but I'm still both amazed and profoundly grateful that Denny and I survived its dangers. I'm grateful, too, that more than one Axis submarine will no longer... However, that's a part of our story. A story which begins late on an overcast night in a certain East Coast harbor. One of the largest of the vessels anchor there, an oil tanker. The watchman pauses suddenly to listen. His attention caught by an unaccustomed sound.
I wouldn't think it's that.
Hey, who's making that carnation noise? What's going on out there? All right. All right, speak up. Who's there?
Shut up, Joe.
What?
Keep your trap shut, mister.
Say, who are you? How'd you get aboard? What's going on around here?
I'll ask the questions, Joe.
My name ain't Joe.
It is to me. Want to earn some cash?
How?
Why, easy, Joe, easy. If anybody asks you about tonight, why, just make out like you didn't hear nothing and you didn't see nothing. Get it?
You're up to something crooked.
Then you ain't interested,
no, I ain't. Yeah, you go on, get out of here now. Go on. Get out before I call the cops.
Okay, Joe. Don't make no difference to me. Penny saves, a penny earns.
Hey, what?
Like it better that way, Joe?
Oh, heaven bless you, Captain Drummond, sir. Heaven bless you. I knew you'd help me.
Yes, I will, Mrs. Regan. I will. I give you my word.
Come over to my office.
Help you. And quite properly, too. Did it unfriendly if you hadn't. But, Mrs. Regan.
Yes, sir.
What makes you think I can do more than the police? You say they found your husband in the alley behind, what was the name of that tavern?
The Blue Pelican, sir. Tis near the Dutch and a horrible place it is, sir.
Hmm. Well, this sounds like it. And that was when?
Oh, most a week ago now, sir. And they claim it must have happened in some kind of a fight. Claim my tin must have been drunk. So they smelled of liquor, something terrible.
Tin? Smell of liquor? I don't believe it.
That's just it. Tim never drank a drop in his life, sir. I told the police.
If the odor of whiskey was found on Tim, either he'd been forced to swallow it before his murder, or it was sprinkled on his clothing afterwards. His murderer had a reason for it. Mrs. Regan, will you go home now and believe that Tim's murderer will be found?
I know he'll be, Captain Drummond, if you say it, sir.
Yes, I have your address. You'll hear it from me the moment I news.
Goodbye, sir. I don't know how to thank you.
And why should you? Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
Denny.
Yes, sir.
Get our things, will you? We're paying a visit to the docks.
Any luck, Denny? Not a particle, sir. And you, sir?
Nothing. Odd, isn't it? You think someone would have seen poor Regan leave his ship that night? You inquired of everyone I suggested?
Everyone, sir.
Surely, Denny, a watchman leaving an oil tanker that size would have been observed by someone. The fact that he wasn't seems to indicate that his means of departure must have been rather extra. Who's this fellow coming along the wharf?
Most unpleasant-looking chap, sir.
Yes, isn't it?
Evening.
Oh, good evening.
I seen you guys around.
Oh, yes?
Private cops?
Well, no, not exactly. Why?
I heard you asking questions about Tim Regan, a watchman. But you maybe his old lady hired you.
No, Tim was our friend.
Oh, I get it, Joe.
Joe?
Oh, that's nothing. Just the way of calling a guy.
Yes? And so?
I seen Regan that night. I thought maybe you'd like to know. I seen him leaving his ship.
Really?
Yeah. Boy, that guy was cockeyed. South. Walking on rubber legs. I was passing, see? And he yelled, didn't I want to go with him and get a drink? And I told him I'd go soak his head.
And then?
Well, he got his drink, I guess. I didn't pay no attention. I just figured you'd like to know.
Yes. Yes, indeed. Your information is of great value. Probably of more value than you realize.
I'll be seeing you.
Huh? Oh, yes. Yes, I'm sure you will. Denny.
Yes, Captain Drummond, sir.
That fellow said he saw Tim Regan drunk. He lied. If he lied, he undoubtedly had good cause. We're going to follow him.
Oh, but, sir...
Wait, what? You go around the corner of the shed?
Why, yes, I believe he did, sir.
Listen. Hear anything?
Nothing, sir.
Nor do I. Like the dog that didn't bark in the night, that's very strange. If he kept on, we should still hear his footsteps. I wonder...
Oh, don't get too close to the edge of the dock, sir.
Denny, I think...
Oh, Captain Drummond, Denny! Captain Drummond, sir! Where are you? Where are you, sir?
Officer, I say, officer.
It's you. Have you...
No. I'm sorry, fella. Got some of the boys operating the captain hooks, and there's others still searching under the piers. So far, there hasn't been a sign of them.
No, this is horrible.
You didn't see him again after the shots were fired, and after you fell in?
Oh, no, not even for a moment, sir. It was precisely as if he'd vanished into thin air, sir.
Well, what you happened, he must have got sucked under the pilings, and by now, with the tide going out for the last hour, the commissioner himself couldn't tell you where to look. But don't you worry. We'll find the body for you someplace.
Oh, did you say the body?
That's what I said. If he wants his ghost, he'll have to see someone higher up than me.
Hey, here, Bill. Get back here out of the light, you fathead, or I'll kick them gold teeth down your throat.
Bill, cut it out.
Yeah, well, I don't like it much right now. Look, there by that crowd. That the guy was with the dummy you knocked off?
Yeah, that's him.
Okay. Back to the boat.
How long are you going to take?
How should I know? Go on. Get going before I slap you around a little just to keep a figure down. Hiya,
fellas. Good evening, madam.
Want to hear something interesting?
Huh?
Pal of yours just had some tough luck, didn't he?
Yes, but what?
Like to know where's the guy what plugged him?
You mean you know?
Am I? Come on along.
Oh, yes, indeed. Just one moment. I'll get the police.
Oh, no, you don't. Cops ain't coasting.
Oh, but...
Hold it, handsome. I ain't a debating society. I'm just a little lady that's trying to do you a favor because I don't like killers. Maybe I've stuck my neck out too far already. So long, handsome.
No, wait. I'll go with you.
Is
it very far?
Not especially.
Where do we go?
Down this way, along the dock.
It's quite dark.
Yeah.
How did you learn who the fellow is?
Oh, I just happened to hear some of the boys talking. Don't like the guy, so I thought I'd kick him myself by turning him in.
Oh. Isn't that a boat?
Yeah.
What's it doing here?
There's a dock, and that's a harbor, ain't it? Where'd you expect the boat to be? City Hall?
No, that's it, Joe. What? But you're the...
Yeah, that's right. I'm me. See this heater? Oh, behave, brother, behave.
Oh, boy. Can't find the way, brother. Come on, let's swim. Get started. We got business to do.
What is the desperate game that Val and Slim are playing? A game so desperate that they murder to avoid detection. You'll learn more about these questions in just a few moments. We left Denny being shanghaied by Bell and Slim, who told Denny that they were moving into the person he believes has murdered Bulldog Drummond. Their boat pulls away from the pier. It is a few minutes later. Bell is speaking.
Let's swing out a little before we round it. Hell, Shane. That's a problem. No,
he's all right.
Trying to
love his man after
the cost. Look there. Huh? Bob's coming in off the ocean
mighty thick, too. What time is it? 9:30. Hey, this don't mean
we're making another trip tonight, does it?
Sure.
But we ain't
heard
from Snyder.
Well, I got those as well. Come on, skip on it. He's coming, I want to be back to the barge before he gets there. Okay, up the I'll make it fast.
Hey, what about Handsome here?
Oh, forget him, he'll keep. He's tied up beautifully, ain't you, Handsome?
Madam, as a gentleman's gentleman, there's nothing I can say which will pass a gentleman's gentleman's lips.
Hey, Belle, that's double talk.
Let's cheer on him, don't it? All right, take a leg and come on up on the bar.
Okay, okay, I'm coming.
Oh.
Say, Benny, would you mind rolling over a bit? They're on my leg, you know.
This is Captain Dublin, sir.
Yes, quiet. Give a powder, if you please, Benny. Oh, that's splendid.
But you're not dead,
sir, am I? But isn't this an abrupt way of breaking the news to me?
Oh, but, sir, you were shot. The police are looking for your body.
And I'm sorry, but they won't find it.
Captain Drummond, I confess it, sir. I simply don't know what to say. I am completely bewildered.
Oh, but it's all quite simple.
But, sir, when that horrible chap fired at
me, I did the most natural thing and removed myself. You see, Danny, it seems quite clear now that Slim realized it was odd no one had seen Regan leave the tanker. Therefore, to soothe our suspicions, he volunteered that holy mythical tale of his.
Oh, yes, quite so, sir.
But when he eavesdropped on us, he immediately discovered that he made a mistake. That we and Regan didn't drink. So he'd have to erase his mistake by erasing me.
And you deliberately let him think you're dead, sir.
Of course.
And you're watching where we searched for you, sir.
Then I was within 30 feet of you the entire time.
30 feet? Incredible, sir.
When I spotted Bell's him, I secreted myself under this confidant. And, as you must by this time be aware, here I am. Oh, that's a point, too, isn't it? Just where are we?
Well, it's become quite foggy, sir, but we do seem to be a good bit offshore. But you aren't diving.
Good afternoon. Oh, of course, Danny. I completely forgot. Here, yeah, turn around and up.
But, sir.
Sorry, I'm afraid you'll have to wait. That's a tugboat. And unless I'm greatly mistaken, it's going to tie up to that barge.
Never mind that, Coraline. There is not time. Do please call Slim to the deckhouse. I must return to shore. There are things that is necessary for you to know. Now then, I will repeat your instructions. There must be no mistake. Captain Lister will take you to a point 3 miles off Reef Island, where you will drop anchor. There you will be out of the way of the harbor traffic on the shipping lanes. You will then send out the code message. Your wireless has been repaired?
Sure.
Good. The message consists of two words. Thick fog.
Yeah.
Do you have that?
Thick fog.
You will send that message for precisely 2 minutes. No more, no less. Then you will do in every respect exactly as you have done before, Fräulein. You will simply wait. Captain Lister has been instructed to sound his fog horn at regular intervals. That will serve as a guide.
Yeah.
You will be met by 2 submarines, both of them badly in need of the fuel carried on this barge. If you do not meet them, if they fail to receive this fuel...
Goodbye, you both, huh?
Yes, and also...
Huh?
Goodbye, Fräulein.
Denny.
Yes, Captain.
I've been doing into eavesdropping. Chap will be along in a moment to use this motorboat to get ashore. I'll have to leave you tied and undercover aboard the barge. They're going to take you inside the deckhouse.
But they mean to kill me,
Denny,
sir.
Denny, we're on to bigger game than we ever dreamed of. So big that... Well, there's not time to explain now. You'll have to take my word for it. But trust me, will you?
Of course, sir.
Denny, you've got intestinal fortitude.
Oh, really? Is it serious, sir?
Serious. As a matter of fact, Denny... It may be the death of you.
Oh, I see what a beastly noise out there. Must they make all that racket?
This is as far as the tug goes, Handsome.
I'll let the anchor go, Bill.
No, stay here. I can manage. Well, Handsome, this is where you get off. Too bad you ain't got a round-trip ticket.
A round-trip ticket?
That's what I said, fella. Slim.
Yeah?
Suppose you show Handsome the way out, huh?
Show him... Oh! Yeah, you bet.
Goodbye, Handsome. Ain't it too bad we won't never get to know each other better?
You hear that, Joe? What an extremely coarse sense of humor.
Uh-huh. She wasn't joking.
Say, what are you doing?
Just getting my gun. Guess why, Joe?
Okay.
On your feet.
Well, now, really, you can't.
Hey, Captain Drummond, careful, sir.
Yes. Oh. Like that, my friend?
Oh, beautifully done, sir.
That should hold him for a bit, Denny. Now, then, we'll have to work fast. Get you out of these ropes first.
That female, sir.
He's talking with the captain of the tug, Denny. We'll have time, I think. Just 1 second now. There you are.
I'm afraid I'm feeling a bit cramped, sir.
Look at.
And what now, sir?
No use taking the crew. Too many for us. Let's see. Oh, this is what I'm after.
Well, let's tell Wireless, sir.
Yes, I know. It'll take a moment to warm up, I imagine. Let's have a practice go at it, eh? Kind of rusty at this.
You intend to get a message through to the proper authorities, sir?
Right, Jimmy. Keep a lookout at that forward porthole, will you?
Of course, sir.
See our hostess?
Well, not a sign of her, sir.
Maybe he ain't looking in the right direction.
Oh, my word.
Don't touch that gun. I'm nuts about loud noises. Might pull this trigger just to hear it go bang, bang.
Never mind, Benny. Good evening, Belle.
Kind of cool, ain't it? You must be the gent Slim claimed he plugged. Oh, that's Slim there on the floor? Yeah. Well, that's what he gets for taking too much for granted. Kind of had it coming.
Yes, Belle, I think he did.
Just getting ready to use the wireless, huh? Okay, that's fine. Send out a message for me. 6-5. Just send 2 words. You know how to spell them?
I might manage.
Any objection?
Under the circumstances, no.
Wouldn't be healthy to send anything but what I told you.
Really? What's to prevent?
A bullet in the stomach.
Oh.
You see, I can't be tricked, pal. I can work that gadget as good as you can.
Well, you're a most remarkable woman.
Yeah?
And likely to come to a most remarkable end. Now, what was that message? 2 words, wasn't it? Ah, yes. Thick fog.
Hey.
Looks like our friend Slim is coming around, Bill.
Okay, man. Hey, Slim. Slim! Snap out of it.
Well, how'd I get out of here on deck?
I brought you out so you could get a little air.
Oh. You're the guy that slugged me.
You're out of sorts, aren't you, sir?
Oh, sit down. Wobbling on your tent like a kid.
Yeah, I don't feel so good. Say, how come these guys ain't been bumped off yet?
Simply that Belle's got a soft place in her heart for you, Sam.
Huh?
You see, she thought it would be a rather nice gesture if she waited until you could manage the killing yourself. You know how women are, sentimentalists.
A wise guy, huh?
Oh, and while we're waiting for your submersible friends, Oh, yes, where are they, I wonder?
And be alarmed. Don't let it worry you. What was you going to say?
Well, several questions have been puzzling me a little. Tim Regan, for instance. You killed him, didn't you, Slim?
Why should I tell you anything, Joe?
Well, after all, neither Denny or I are likely to repeat it, are we?
I guess you ain't. Yeah, I knocked him off. What about it?
And smuggled his body into that alley behind the tavern?
That's right.
But why? He couldn't have discovered you stealing oil by any chance, could he? You couldn't have been tapping the pipeline from that tanker to the dock.
Say, Captain Lister's cut the foghorn. Must have sighted something.
Wait a second. Yeah, it's them, Sam. Sam?
The submarines?
Yeah. Over there on the left.
Yeah, well, sure, there they are. Well, I'll rig up the pumps. Hey, Bill, what's that?
What?
Here, over this way.
It's a destroyer! A destroyer!
Destroyer?
Right over your boat! Straight over!
You can't stop. They're running us down.
I know you don't.
I told you, will you? Let's go. You want us both to die? Let's go!
Back to the smashing climax of our mystery in just a moment. Thrown from the barge into the water by the impact of the destroyer that came knifing through the fog, Bulldog Drummond found himself struggling for his life with a man driven out of his mind by rage and fear.
Fool, let's go. You
drown
us, I tell you. You done it. I
Captain Seven! Slim. Oh, sir, here. Here's his plane, sir. I'm diving. Trying to find Slim. Who went crazy? I have to fight him. Afraid he's drowned. can't seem to locate them at all.
The explosions I heard, sir.
Depth bombs. Destroyer going after those subs. We don't hear them now. Must be finished. Maybe they can pick us up.
Ahoy, the destroyer! Hello!
And there you have it, Commander. At the cost of nothing more than a few buckle plates, you bagged yourself two submarines and an assorted litter of racketeers. Once more, you've got a lead to an enemy agent. In town, of course, but Bell can give you enough evidence for an indictment. Good hunting, eh?
Excellent hunting, Captain Drummond.
Speaking of your pardon, sir.
Yes, then, what is it?
Yes, sir, perhaps I was stupid, but really, sir, I still haven't the slightest notion how you managed to bring this destroyer to our rescue.
It's very easy. I first sent out the code message and changed my style of sending a bit and tapped out an SOS.
An SOS, sir?
Precisely. I gave a position beyond Reef Island, so the vessels coming to our rescue from the harbor would be forced to approach near our actual position. Commander Dovetier, thinking himself on an errand of mercy, heard the whistles of the tug and assumed it marked his objective.
Oh, but sir, how did you dare send such a message with that woman listening, sir? She warned you that she couldn't be tricked, sir, that she understood the operation of the wireless.
On the contrary, Danny, although she wasn't aware of it, she told me the exact opposite.
But sir, I distinctly heard her.
Danny, you distinctly heard her try to bluff me. Fleming was a wireless operator, not Bell. None of the world else would choose to keep us alive until he came to it. Oh, and speaking of the wireless, Commander, would it be possible to radio a personal message ashore?
Well, I think in this case we might make an exception.
It's to our Mrs. Timothy Regan at 815 Water Street.
Yes?
Follow him. The rat that killed Tim is at the bottom of the Atlantic. And Commander, you spell rat. M-O-E-G-I.